Hi. As you may know, to open a menu item, you press the Alt key, then you'll notice that there's a dash under the letter that you need to use to be able to open that menu item. For example, if I use Alt T, the Tools menu will open. If I use Alt G, the Group menu will open. Now, the normal behavior in Macs is, let's say, the Alt-T that opens the Tools menu is at the same time associated with another command inside Max. The normal behavior is that that command has the priority, has the precedence over the menu item. But some users on the Autodesk forum claimed that in some rare cases, this is not happening, even though personally I never had this problem. But if you have also, if you encounter this issue, in this video you will learn how to remove the Alt association with the menu items. But also, in case you like to add an Alt key association with some menu items that they don't have already a shortcut. For example, now if I click the Alt button, you'll see that, for example, the interactive, it doesn't have any dash under it. That means it doesn't have any dash under any of its letters. That means it doesn't have a shortcut. Also the content, the same thing. Arnold, Phoenix, etc. So first let's learn how to remove the Alt association. First, we go to Customize menu, Customize user interface, and we go to Menus tab. Here we have all the menu items that you see here. Let's say I want to remove the association with the Tools menu. So I click the Tools, right click, choose Edit menu item name. Here sometimes in some cases this is unchecked, so check it if it's unchecked. And here you'll see that there is this symbol and it is placed behind the letter that is the shortcut. For in the case of Tools, the shortcut is Alt and the T letter. So you place the AND symbol behind the T. In case of graph editor, for example, the graph editors, edit menu item, check this option. You see that the AND is behind this D letter. So I will go back to Tools. Edit menu item, I just remove the AND, click OK, and close. Now if I press the Alt, as you can see, there is no dash under Tools. So now if I use the Alt T, nothing will happen. The other menu is still working, Alt E, Alt G, etc. Now if you like to, let's say I want to create a shortcut for interactive, I go back to customize user interface, menus, interactive, right click, edit menu item name, check the customize name. Now I can choose any letter of these, but I will choose the letter I, add an AND symbol behind the I, click OK, and then close. Now if I use the Alt I, as you can see, the interactive menu opens up. Now the Alt I will unhide a box I have here. just a simple box converted to editable poly. To prove that the command have the if the same shortcut is associated with a command, the command has the priority over the menu item. The Alt I is at the same time a shortcut for a command inside the polygon subobject level, where if you select a polygon, if you choose Alt I, it is the shortcut for the hide unselected. And as you can see, the menu item didn't open. So I will unhide all again. If I go out from the subobject level, now I'm on the object level. If I use the Alt I, if I use the alt, sometimes it hangs a little bit. It's okay. If I use the Alt I now, it is the interactive menu. If I decided, for example, to create an association for the interactive menu using the N letter, not the I, then it will not work, because the Alt N is a shortcut for normal align. And to prove that, I go back to customize menu, interactive, right click, edit menu item. I will remove the end from here and put it behind the N. Click OK, close. And now, as you can see, the dash is under the N. So now if I use Alt N, it will opens up the it will activate the normal align, and it's telling me that no objects are selected. So basically that's it for this video. I hope you learned something, and if you like the video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you next time.